السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Wherever you are and whenever you are following the bad incidents on Friday in the car parking in Birmingham, we rushed by the car, me and my colleague, to rush to catch the 3:45 flight there. And we had our boarding pass, but went to the gate, and when we were on the gate, we found the security man, which belongs to the airline company, as well as the lady there standing waiting for us. And he asked us to put our hand luggage in a small box like this, see if it fits or not. It didn't fit. I told the man quietly or nicely, this is an international standard. I said, the international standard is not our standard. Our standard is different. So, sir, you have to pay £50 to us. And if you don't pay it, you're not going to board the airplane. And on the way back, if you don't tell us 24 hours before you board, you'll be another £50. And if you pay £20 now, so it will be £70 in and out. I was furious and mad as usual, as you have seen me in the car parking of the Somali brother before. And I called them, this is a cover-up theft by your company, and this is my last time to travel in with your airline anymore. My son-in-law was with me and was trying to cool me down. I said, I'm not going to travel. He said, no, if you don't travel, we're not going to travel. And that means that we're not going to give the condolences to our in-laws in Aberdeen. And he was very cooler than me and more wiser than myself. And he cooled me down and went to pay the £70 for both ways. And I went there in a very bad situation. My nerves were actually boiling, and I could not be able to understand how people like this steal money from the passengers, which is this cover-up theft. I couldn't be able to sleep on the same day when I was in Aberdeen, because thinking about how I was not treating the Somali brother in a very nice way. And second day, when we came back to Birmingham City on Saturday, I went to the Somali brother in the center, and I was trying to apologize to him in front of his the children there. And I remember before I go there, I remember before this, the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, what was the hadith called? And the strong one is not the one who can fight you physically and knock you down physically, but is the one who can control himself or herself when they become angry. And I went to the Somali brother, I apologized to him, I kissed his head, and I wanted to kiss his hand and feet in front of the students. I said, no, brother, we knew you, my apology to you, and became very nice. What to learn from this? First of all, you have to control your manner when it becomes, when your soul becomes angry, and try to control it and being controlled. You have to respect your age. You have to respect your social status. You have to respect your experience, value, and your social status in the society. And you have to respect the beautiful image that the society drawing or making for you. Because they know that you are Mr. So-and-so, you are Mrs. So-and-so, and you are such a nice and noble woman and man, so you should not actually spoil it. Jazakumullah khair. Next time, I should control my anger. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.